everybody. Got a lot of little bait fish popping this morning out here. Seriously? Thank you, buddy. Get you off of here. Appreciate you coming to visit. He's not bad. He's not huge, but he's not bad either. Yeah, I guess he is kind of small. I had him gill hooked. This is number two for me today. And this one came on. A 3/4 ounce for a king red eye shad. Alright, buddy. I'm going to let you go. Thank you. Little dinker. Oh, little fool. You got up here in the mud. There you are. There you are. All right. Got one on the top water, one on the red eye shad. I had a feeling they'd bite something like this. I've caught big ones on that particular lure that I'm throwing right now. It's a chartreuse perch color. I got this one at Shields. You can get them like a Bass Pro Shop, Tackle Warehouse. Walmart usually doesn't carry anything that big, but they do have some half ounce Strike King red eye shad there that I've seen. It's a little bit of muck out there, not a whole bunch to really matter, but you still need to get it off your hooks when you bring it in, because it will affect the way that the bait comes through the water. A little wiggle. This is a 6'6" medium heavy loose speed stick. The combo is the American Hero. It's a 4 or 5 bearing system. I had it for, I don't know, since the pandemic started, and caught some nice fish on it. Caught some 3-pounders. getting smaller. That's just exactly how Gary got stuck. Just exactly how. Quick release on that. My stuff being that far away from me, so I'm gonna go down and get it, bring it right back up here. I'm not gonna move too far from this spot today, not when I'm catching fish. I'm not gonna bore you with the walk. I'll turn the camera off. Three small bass for me today, so far. Maybe there's a big one in here for me to catch today, who knows. Hitting stuff as it come through, hitting a rock or something. That's really right along the bottom. It's hitting. Really feel it. Oh, that was some grass or a rock or something that I hung up on there. About cast halfway down the lake. This one's caught too, so I really can't see a reason to switch to another color or anything else like that. The one thing I like about having the wind behind your back. turtle. I caught a turtle. Oh my goodness. Get you flipped over there so you don't die. There you go, buddy. Caught a damn turtle. That's a first. Yeah, but I'm only catching little ones.
So far, it might change.
It might. Trying not to pull a Gary here.
Yeah, let's be careful of that.
All right, buddy. Thank you for biting. Appreciate you. Oh, wow.
I don't know how that goes.
Yep.
Braid, too.
Oh, shit. I got braid scissors in my box over there.
Yeah, I got some. They should cut it. I'm just going to cut it all and retie.
Alright.
I'll snag there. I've been worried at first. Pulled real hard. Lure came flying past my fucking face.
Looks like the rain has stopped and almost looks like the sun's trying to come out. Yep. No use changing when it's catching fish. So if I count the turtle, it's six. But the turtle, he actually got off right at the bank. Yeah, he was like foul hooked. I had him like right where his head goes in is where I had a shell, but the hook wasn't in anything but an open space. So he's all tucked away and I'm just... But yeah, he got off right there. landed on his back, so I had to take the rod and flip him over, you know. He was laying there like, help me! Gary was catching fish left and right over. I mean, it was just like bam, 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 bam. And I walked over to him on the first one, and I says, hey, can I feel that? Can I see that? He says, yeah. And I reached over and I you know, like petted it. And I says, I just wanted to see what they feel like, man. Yeah. Aww. It's gonna come out. I didn't have my thumb on it tight enough. Going into the wind, you know. I'll do that sometimes, just to remind myself I ain't that good. Right. Well, I've been doing it more often than not this year because I've been trying to fish with my settings looser so I can get better distance and a little more control. Oh man, you know what today is, right? Friday the 13th. Whoa. All right, we're good. My bad. I'll stay more to your left. Well, I knew what I was gonna do if they crossed. I was just gonna stop and let you sink. Right. Oh, I gill hooked him. I ran into him. That's what it was.
Ran into him.
Yep.
Snagged him.
No, he's got one in his mouth, corner of his mouth. So maybe he's come up and yeah. Right, there's that one. There we go. All right, another little guy. I hooked him pretty good there, you can see. That may have been the biggest one today. I mean, they haven't been big at all. Biting on this big-ass 3/4 ounce lipless, you know. With weather like this, it kind of triggers the fall feeding frenzy sometimes, you know what I'm saying? I'm not there by any means today, but fishing something like that out here today, Adam, it wouldn't surprise me if you get your PB today. Nice. The way you're fishing it. Now, I used to fish this place every day. This was the only place I would fish. Kind of like you with your spot, you know? When I first started bass fishing and using these lipless crankbaits, this one right here that I'm using in one day caught a 5-pounder and 2 3-pounders. And it was, yeah, it was right off of this point, throwing straight out towards the dock. And it was on that mock smash.
That's where they were at that day.
I'll go to
some spots out of my spot where I had good days, like I told you, and I can't even pick up a bite there.
I'll go to my
go there and catch fish after fish after fish for the longest. It's like they move.
You send me just about every picture when you catch a fish that's of any decency, you know. And I used to save all my pictures too when, you know, before I got a GoPro.
4 years ago, I've been throwing the bigger baits for 4 years
now. Go on to my Facebook page tonight, man, when you get time, or tomorrow, whenever, and take a look at all my pictures I got posted. A lot of them you saw in Springfield. Bass anglers? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
A lot of them you saw on that page. But a lot of them before 2023, I hadn't posted. No. I paused it a little bit. I was going to put my new $10.44 spinning rod on my, or put my Lewis LZR Pro onto that $10 spinning rod and bring it today. I was using it the day you first met me and caught a 312 not long after you left. Gary caught a 3-2 or something like that. We were right there together. He caught his first.
That one Ethan Wright, which is the one I showed you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we did that one day, right? Wow.
Little guys.
So I'm catching the ones that you're fishing with.
Uh,
But you know what? I'll stand here and catch these little fuckers all day long. I ain't got no problem with that.
I do love it. You should see it. Here, I'm going to grab it so you can at least just see it in the water.
Hit you here.
We'll put a little nail weight in the bottom there. And then only go through. Them are the type of hooks I got. He usually got some with weed guards, but I need to go to Shields or somewhere and get them. Shields or Academy, I bet I'll have them. But yeah.
I'm going to turn my camera off for a minute.